France's presidential election dominates the international newspaper at this Paris shop, a clear sign how important the first round of voting really was. For Brussels and even Ukraine, the nightmare scenario was avoided. Following Donald Trump's triumph and Britain's Brexit, there were real fears of a second round runoff between Marine Le Pen and Jean-Luc Mélenchon, the far-right and far-left candidate whose pro-Kremlin rhetoric has set off alarm bells in Eastern Europe. However, it was a political novice that stole the show. Emmanuel Macron, a pro-EU candidate, took the lead in the first round of the election with almost 24%. While visiting Moscow, the EU foreign policy chief, Federica Mogherini, welcomed the result.
What I tweeted yesterday night was that for me, seeing together EU and French flags welcoming the results of Emmanuel Macron was the hope of a generation. Seeing together the European and the French flags is affirming that a people identity and a person identity can be at the same time French and European. And this is how large parts of my generation, which is also Emmanuel's generation, feels about.
Analysts believe Le Pen is increasingly unlikely to be France's leader, as former presidential candidates throw their weight behind Macron. That support for the former economy minister has also come from the current French president. He said, "Faced with such a risk, it's impossible to stay silent or to remain indifferent. We have to do something. There is a clear choice. As for me, I will vote for Emmanuel Macron. In addition, I thank all the political figures and associations who, over and above the reservations they might have about his manifesto, have called on people to do the same." Sunday's outcome is a huge defeat for the two center-right and center-left groupings that have dominated French politics for 60 years.